The most compelling action is on CBS Sports. CBS Sports presentation of Prelude to a Championship is sponsored by Honda. Experience the thrill of driving in the all-new Prelude.
Welcome to Indianapolis. It's time to play for the championship right here in the heart of Hoosier country. It's time to put an exclamation point on the NCAA tournament. For the fans, it's time to come on into the RCA Dome and celebrate the beginning of spring with the crowning of a champion. For Kentucky, it's time to show what it means to be a veteran and time to answer the question, can you repeat? With a resounding, yes, I can. And for Arizona, it's time to show their fans that sometimes a new kid on the championship block might be the best. So who will it be? It's time to find out. Bring it on. Time for the game and the goosebumps to begin. Hi again, everybody. I'm Pat O'Brien. Welcome to Prelude to a Championship. Tonight, a young Arizona team is looking to complete an unprecedented 11-day stretch with victories over three number one seeds, who also happen to be college basketball's three all-time winningest schools. Arizona has already defeated Kansas and North Carolina, and tonight they face Kentucky, the winningest program in college basketball history. But Kentucky is on the road to repeat, aiming to become only the second school since 1973 to win back-to-back titles. And joining me this evening is Clark Kellogg and Duke head coach Mike Krzyzewski, who coached the last repeat champions in 1991 and 1992. Good evening, guys. Ready to go?
Ready to roll.
Let's talk about Arizona. They've been looking for respect, and I think they have it now, don't you?
Pat, Arizona's legit. Beating two number one seeds, and in the first two rounds, coming back from two 10-point second-half deficits. They've been in the pressure cooker before. And tonight, there's a lot of pressure, but I think they know how to handle it.
And Kentucky's always had the respect, but now they just step it up a little notch, don't they, Clark?
And you talk about stepping it up. We can talk about a number of factors when you talk about keys to winning big games. But one of the most important in my mind, Pat, is that you need your marquee guys to step up. And in Ron Mercer, Kentucky has a guy that can do that. He's like a king in checkers. He can make moves and go places that other pieces on the board can't.
And here's the question all Arizona fans want to know, Mike. Can Arizona win?
Yes, they can, and they can do it by making good decisions in full court and in the half court, decisions that will lead to scores.
All right, a short time ago, our Michelle Tafoya caught up with Arizona head coach Lute Olson and asked him what he told his teams.
Well, the whole thing has been, hey, just have fun, enjoy the moment, play hard, and don't leave anything on the court. Give it every ounce of energy you've got, and I think you know, they've done a great job. It is probably a year early, but we all know how lucky you have to be to get here, and so they're going. I mentioned to them after the last one. Well, as long as we're here, we might as well get the last one. Make it a complete trip.
Earlier, Andrea Joy spoke with the other Wildcat coach, Kentucky's Rick Pitino.
Coach, such a physical battle for your kids Saturday night. How concerned are you about their ability to bounce back from that?
I'm not as concerned about that as I am about guarding the Arizona basketball team on the perimeter and in transition. I think we're ready to play. I don't think that's a problem for us. We practiced very hard, and we went very light yesterday, so it's been like a day at the beach for these guys.
You're attempting to defend a national title with almost a completely different team from last year. How would you describe their frame of mind coming into this game? Are they more emotional?
I think so. I think last year's team was a dominating basketball team, physically tried to overpower everybody when they left the locker room. This team focuses on every little thing that the opposition will do to try and gain a victory. They know they need edges along the way, a little bit of luck, but we've had both along this way.
Okay, best of luck. Thank you.
And for Arizona, what does the opposition do, and what do they have to do?
Kentucky will come right at them, and what Arizona has to do is use the dribble. They have to go by Kentucky's traps and create some scoring opportunities. Dickerson and Miles Simon.
That's exactly the key, but it won't be easy. Kentucky's perimeter guys, Ron Mercer, Wayne Turner, and Anthony Epps, excellent individual defenders.
They'd love to see that 20 from Miles Simon tonight. Prelude to a championship will continue in a moment. Monday night, Indianapolis, Indiana is the basketball capital of the world, and outside and inside, they wait the crowning of a new champion, and it's time for Arizona and Kentucky. So let's send you down to Jim Nance and Billy Packer, who have the best seats in the house, and now, so do you, gentlemen.
All right, thank you very much, Pat. Billy, great to be with you courtside again for the national championship game. Where has Cinderella been in the 90s? We have not had a Cinderella champion, really, in this tournament since Kansas of 1988. We were trying to calculate
the 80s, Jim, was the Cinderella century. I mean, the Cinderella decade. The 90s, we haven't had one. This could be the first.
And Arizona, if it wins tonight, would complete what would be the most amazing 11-day run in championship history, because they have taken on now already two of the winningest teams in basketball history. Kansas, the third all-time winningest team. They knocked them out in the Sweet 16, beat North Carolina here in the Final Four on Saturday in the semifinals. They'll take on the winningest all-time program tonight in Kentucky. That could be, well, the top three and all three number one seeds, which has never happened before. How about Arizona? How did it get here?
Well, Jim, they've done some great basketball playing. One of the things, they were down 15-4 in their game on Saturday, and then it was Miles Simon taking over on baskets just like this. The other thing that's interesting about this club, their interior defense was outstanding against North Carolina. Here's Bramlett on one of the eight blocks they had, and of course, the man from the hour with six threes in the game. Even though he didn't call this one to be a bank shot, it hits nothing but net. And in the case of Kentucky, Jim, they have won with an outstanding point guard factor in Turner. Here was a great play where he penetrated, kicked out to Cameron Mills, who was waiting, as Kentucky always did, for the patented three. Now, pressure points. 26 turnovers by Minnesota turned into 23 points for Kentucky. Here's Mercer getting two of that 23. And of course, one of the things Kentucky does better than anybody is penetrate, be patient, kick out, and hit the three. Paget waiting, Paget hits, a patented three-point shot for Kentucky.
And the Wildcats take the floor looking for back-to-back national championships. Only Duke has done it in the last 24 years. Billy, you talked about their pressure, and during the tournament, because of that press, they have forced 100 turnovers amounting to 99 points. But Arizona thinks it can beat the press tonight. Tell us about it.
Their defense becomes their offense. Here we see man-to-man pressure full court. Kentucky will force the ball one side or the other. When the side has been dictated, they will then go ahead into a double-team situation. The three remaining players then will take a zone position. Here we're going to see in the center, zone position taken. Epps is going to try to figure out and anticipate where the pass is going to be made. When he makes the anticipated move, he picks it off. Here we'll see the double-team trap. Epps in the middle. He looks, he steals, and now Kentucky goes from defense to offense, hits down inside. Two more for Kentucky off the defense.
All right, Billy, there will be a Wildcat strike in Indianapolis. By whom? Arizona or Kentucky? We'll find out next.
Coverage of the NCAA National Championship game is sponsored by Genuine Chevrolet, Pepsi, Pennzoil, and by Nike.
To introduce the starting lineups, the pride of Waco, Texas, for the 20th year, Mr. Frank Fallon.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the RCA Dome for tonight's NCAA game between the Arizona Wildcats and the Kentucky Wildcats. Now let's meet the starting lineups. For Arizona at forward, a 6'8 junior from Sebastopol, California, number 21, Bennett Davison. For Kentucky at forward, a 6'7 sophomore from Nashville, Tennessee, number 33, Ron Mercer. For Arizona at forward, a 6'5 junior from Seattle, Washington, number 23, Michael Dickerson. For Kentucky at forward, a 6'9 sophomore from Louisville, Kentucky, number 34, Scott Padgett. For Arizona at center, a 6'11 sophomore from Albuquerque, New Mexico, number 42, A.J. Bramley. For Kentucky at center, a 6'10 freshman from Toronto, Canada, number 42, Jamal McGlure. For Arizona at guard, a 6'1 freshman from Phoenix, Arizona, number 10, Mike Debbie. For Kentucky at guard, a 6'2 sophomore from Boston, number 5, Wayne Turner. For Arizona at guard, a 6'5 junior from Fullerton, California, number 34, Miles Simon. For Kentucky at guard, a 6'2 senior from Lebanon, Kentucky, number 25, Anthony F. And the coaches from Arizona in his 24th season, Lute Olson. From Kentucky in his 15th season, Rick Pitino.
For Arizona, its first time ever in the title game. Kentucky's ninth. Kentucky has won the championship six times. Looking for a repeat championship. Billy, your analysis before tip-off.
Well, Jim, Wildcats, both of them have that nickname, but I'm talking about Kentucky pressure. They forced 26 turnovers against Minnesota for 23 points. They're the all-time Kentucky steal leaders. Simon says, we talk about big men coming up in big games. Simon against Mercer tonight. Let's see what happens there. One of them has to take the lead for their club. The third point in defense, trying to be a little cute here, and I'm talking about the defense against the three-point field goal. Everybody talks about offensive three-point shooting. Defense against the three is going to be a key tonight for both teams. And gone with the wind. We saw all four teams on Saturday shoot very poorly in this arena. There is no win factor. There just was tough defense. Let's see who comes up with good field goal shooting tonight.
Well, the officials, the three T's, Tim, Ted, and Tom, hopefully we won't have to call on a fourth T before this game is over.
Let's hope we don't have any T's. The T was a big, big play on Saturday.
In the Minnesota-Kentucky semifinal, Arizona in the dark blue uniforms, and Simon almost stole the tip, but Kentucky controls. Kentucky 35-4, Arizona 24-9 on the year.
Dickerson on Mercer, not Davison Mercer. Nice switch by Simon.
Bibby got a hand in there to steal it. Davison takes off. No whistle. And McGlure retrieves for Kentucky.
Great help by Turner because Davison's one of the best dunkers in the college game.
Turner, who moved to the point from SEC tournament time, has been really successful.
Nice help by Bramlett.
Turner, jump shot, in and out, tipped up by McGlure twice, and stripped away by Dickerson. McGlure was ready to go up for a third attempt. Bibby in traffic, scores the game's first points.
Terrific crossover dribble by Bibby. He was under control the whole time and went by one of the best defenders in the game in Turner. Arizona really getting out on the threes.
Mercer misses his first shot of the night. McGlure very active on the offensive glass. Turner off balance for Kentucky's first two.
Jim, Turner is amazing inside the foul line as a shooter. He is woeful beyond the three and really doesn't even look to take him. But when he penetrates, he can shoot.
Dickerson, whistle first, and they take away the made basket by Dickerson. It's so important that that man get off to a good start. He has struggled in March.
Absolutely, Jim. Only 4 for 25 of threes in the NCAA. Here's the road to Jim in terms of how did they get there. And of course, those first two games, Arizona was behind by 10 in the second half in both of them.
The largest margin of victory is 8. And there's Turner, not this time. That foul at the other end on Davison on the inside. Arizona will get the ball back. Kentucky, now while Arizona has won all tight games, the largest margin of victory for Arizona was 8. Kentucky's average margin has been 14. With Iowa playing him the tightest, a 6-point win. Scott Padgett hit a big three late to help seal it. Simon, turn around.
Inside the zone. There's Davidson with that quick leaping ability. One of the best players in college basketball getting off the floor quickly. So Kentucky hasn't shown their press yet because they haven't gotten in the mode to score and be able to get into it, but they've shown zone and man-to-man. It's going to be interesting, Jim, to see how much that game Saturday against Minnesota took out of Kentucky.
Epps with the three, and he said yesterday, I love shooting in domes. And he harkened back to last year playing up in Minneapolis in the dome up there, hitting his first three threes of the night.
There's the double down by Kentucky. Somebody's got to be open opposite. Arizona can't do it.
Bibby firing back short. From behind, Bramlett reached in to pick his pocket. Simon pulls up and was hit on the arm by McGlure.
Jim, both of these teams are extremely quick. Kentucky had trouble with South Carolina, a team that beat them twice this year with three very quick guards. But Kentucky has not faced this year a team that's got five players that can run like Arizona can. So that's going to be an interesting adjustment for Rick Pitino.
Simon, the only returning starter from Arizona's team last year, their top returning scorer and rebounder from 96. And 20-point average in the tournament, but really has been hot in the last two with 30 in the regional final against Providence to win the MVP of the Southeast and 24 against Carolina Saturday.
Arizona shows a little press of their own, but basically a one-man bibby on Turner just making him run because he played 39 minutes, Turner, in that game against Minnesota, so they're going to try to make him run at all times. A little double on Epps. They'll let Turner go because he's not a jump shooter.
Off the arms of Simon, 20 on the shot clock. 6-5 Arizona.
Jim, that was an interesting defensive maneuver by Arizona. When Turner hits and goes away, they double somebody else because they're not worried about the ball being swung over for Turner to take a three-point shot. He's not going to shoot him.
It's only 26%, Bill, as you mentioned, woeful from three.
It's a nice maneuver by Lute Olson.
5 on the shot clock. Padgett left free for the three.
Big mistake by Arizona that time. The one thing you cannot let Kentucky do is let Padgett spot up, Mills when he gets into the game spot up, Epps spot up.
And that's his favorite spot on the floor. Davison wanting the challenge, now goes over, Simon open three. Long board to Dickerson.
Good blocking out by Kentucky.
Way up high, Mercer had it for a moment. Out of bounds, and the under 16 timeout has arrived. Kentucky's hit both of its shots from behind the arc. This one by Padgett, and Kentucky leads 8-6.
This is what I was talking about in regard to Turner. Watch, he has the ball, he's going to hit Epps over here, and then he's going to cut through. Watch what happens. Bibby will go for the double team. They'll let Epps alone. They don't care where he goes outside the three-point line. Excellent maneuver here by Arizona. I guarantee you Rick Pitino is going to see that. He's going to adjust, tell Turner to break inside like that and come back to the basket for a layup.
Here's the full court pressure. There's not been a sub in the game to this point.
Oh, dangerous pass by Bibby. You want to keep that dribble alive at half court. Kentucky really rushing at Dickerson, Jim. They don't want to see him get started.
Bibby gets tipped out to Simon. Dickerson, three. And tipped up by Bramlett. Had a good chance to knock that one down.
Turner, an excellent rebounder. Doesn't mind going in traffic. floor, trying to set the screen to get Turner loose.
Turner just inside the line. Back out to Turner. In the corner, Mercer. That's a three. And off Patchett. Kentucky will bring in Allen Edwards, a junior from Miami who averages 9 a game and missed the two regional games in San Jose with a stress fracture in his right ankle, but back for 12 minutes of play against Minnesota.
Jim, here goes the full court man pressure now. Nobody guarding the man taking the ball out of bounds. Bramlett comes back. He's got to get the ball in the hands of a ball handler. Simon beats it off the dribble. He's got to be careful from behind.
Puts it up with a left hand and a block foul called against McGlure, his second. Billy, this one surprised you, but over the last 10 years, Arizona has the best win percentage in all of college basketball.
Jim, a lot of things, when you really start looking into their program, surprise you a little bit. Arizona ties with Duke with 10 first-round draft choices, the most of any team in the 90s going into the NBA. So they not only have had talent, obviously they've been successful. Probably the thing that shakes everybody up are the early losses that they had in the NCAA tournament. But as we pointed out on Saturday, Lute Olson is 4-0 in regional finals.
Jared Prickett right there, 32, also checking in for the first time, the Iron Man from Kentucky. This is 143rd game, a Kentucky record. He topped Ralph Baird's mark earlier in the tournament. Padgett, same spot where he hit earlier.
And here comes Arizona.
Yeah, they break early. No problem with the press. Bramlett for two and a free throw.
Now, that's what I was talking about before, Jim. Team speed. Kentucky has not faced five guys that can get down the floor like this. Arizona off the rebound created the numbers just by blazing speed by Bramlett and Davison and Dickerson on the wings. Terrific pass. We've seen Bibby so many times with the no look. Freezes the defense with the eyes. Here he is. Boom. Great play. Good hands by Bramlett, who has been just outstanding in the NCAA tournament.
Foul was on Padgett. Mercer's back in. So Aaron Jordan, A.J. Bramlett's three-point play puts Arizona up by three.
There's that curl move. Great help by Davison on Mercer. Pritchett's got to look to take that shot.
Edwards for the baseline. Out of bounds, Arizona ball.
There again, the great quickness of Davison getting down on the baseline. The drive, they give up the baseline, and there is Davison. He came all the way down. He was guarding Prickett all the way up to the top of the key and got down on the baseline for the charge.
Edwards back out. Boy, Davison by this point on Saturday already had three fouls. Not much of a factor in that game, but a big factor in a win over Providence in the regional final.
Solid screen for Dickerson.
Has it stripped away, though. Kentucky off and running. Bibby with the quick hands prevented a layup by Mercer.
How about the speed of Davison to get down there to equalize the numbers when it looked like Kentucky had a three-on-one break?
Cricket kicks it out. Mercer, his first basket of the night, is a three to tie it. At 11.
We've seen twice where men have left. In that case, Mercer left by Dickerson. You cannot do that against Kentucky. You've got to play your man out on the perimeter.
Oh. Tough shot.
Turner battling down inside for the rebound. I would say the pace favors Arizona, Jim, because you got to think the number of minutes guys like Mercer and Turner had to play against Minnesota. Davison, as I mentioned, only played 10 minutes on Saturday. So he has to really be fresh.
Padgett steps in for a two. Shook three from Davison, who gets the rebound. The rest of this Arizona team that played a lot of minutes with tireless on. There's Dickerson. He trips on Patino after bearing the three.
And Rick calls the 20-second timeout for his own safety. But boy, you can imagine how happy Lute Olson is to see that three go down. He was 4-for-25 up to that point from three in the NCAA tournament.
And had missed his last nine shots. dating back to Saturday.
Rick Pitino doing a little leaner, and then Dickerson headed down court. Rick Pitino right there in the coaching box, so nothing illegal.
Not a charge?
No.
Looks like he had position.
Definitely.
Arizona, only the second number four seed to make it to the title game, and Syracuse last year was the other. In fact, this is the seventh time that a four seed has made it to the Final Four. None of them have ever won the championship. Lute Olson's team, fifth in the Pac-10 this year, but the Pac-10 starring in this tournament with an 11-4 record. Epps left open, top of the key, and Eggerson, a freshman from New Orleans, comes in to swipe the first rebound. He had nine on Saturday.
There's that crossover dribble by Bibby again, but Turner right there to face guard him. Great job defensively.
And Epps stepped in to make the steal. Jason Terry, 31, also in for Arizona.
And he's a little small to be guarding Mercer, even though he's the steal leader for Arizona.
Ball on the floor, into the arms of Nazi Muhammad. Shot put by Mercer, Bibby with the board.
Bibby and Turner are both going down inside to get a lot of defensive rebounds.
Jason Terry, who was dehydrated in Saturday's game, is back for practice yesterday. Bramlett, too strong, and Epps, the guards are pulling away the rebounds.
Simon loses Mercer for a second.
Look at Kentucky from inside of the arc, only one of 10. Mercer dumps it to Muhammad, make it 2 of 11.
Terrific job by Nazi, because you have to assume Mercer, coming off that little roll, is going to take his jump shot. He kept his eyes. And here's where you don't want the ball against the press.
Brickett makes the steal. Dishes, no call, and loose ball to Bibby.
Well, that's an interesting way to get the ball up the court.
Way to break the press.
Turnover, turnover. But you do not want the ball down in deep in the corners against Kentucky.
Simon splits the defenders beautifully.
Nazi came out for a hedge move. And Simon, who is a very intelligent basketball player, just split it.
16-13, Arizona.
This is Simon's first Final Four as a player, but he attended six with his dad, Walt Simon, as a spectator. So he knows what it's like to be here.
Look at Terry almost take it away. Donnell Harris will come in for Arizona after the break, as will Cameron Mills for Kentucky.
There's the split.
We'll be right back.
The Final Four again in 2000.
Arizona with four turnovers, Kentucky with five. Final Four next year, visit San Antonio, 99 St. Petersburg, Florida, then back here in 2000.
Epps moves back to the point. Rick Pitino giving Turner a much-needed rest. That's a foul.
Yeah, he was held. Mercer held.
That was going to be on Harris, and he was trying to help Dickerson out. Nobody in college basketball runs the curl move any better than Ron Mercer. He's worked on it hours on end. And when he comes around there, he can square up and elevate for that short jumper.
Teams with three subs on the floor. Mercer and Epps, the only two Kentucky starters. Bibby and Dickerson for Arizona. Epps in the lane. And Donnell Harris.
Donnell Harris, another guy that's come off the bench with Edgerson and really doing a great job off the boards. He had nine rebounds on Saturday.
Bibby, three-pointer. He hit six of them Saturday. He continues to sizzle.
That was about as smooth a three as you'll see. That's a Cameron Mills type three. Here's Mills, and I guarantee you, Terry's not going to let him breathe when he's beyond that three-point line.
Muhammad turnaround. Henderson with position. Yep, tried to sprint the ball out. Mills gets it to go. Cameron Mills. He's had double-figure games, six of the last seven. Bibby easily breaks past.
You can recover.
Kentucky ball. Allen Edwards back in for Kentucky.
And one of the things that Ederson, without the experience, you see Davidson coming back in, was much better off calling the 22nd timeout than getting caught with the ball under Kentucky's basket and giving up an easy two.
Turner back also for Kentucky.
And you see what happens every time Turner comes in the game, Arizona picks him up full court. They're going to make him work every second he has the ball in his hands.
Shot clock malfunction for a moment. Kentucky trying to repeat as national champion. And there's the list. They would join UCLA as the only two programs to ever repeat as champion on two occasions. Well, in UCLA's case, it was many occasions.
It was Adolph Rupp's Fab Five in 1948 and 49 with Beard and Groza. One of the all-time great teams in early NCAA history.
Edwards. And Turner gives it up. Mills. From three. Again, Cameron Mills. He is now the tournament 16 of 22 from three. Nothing short of remarkable.
Well, Jim, that's a breakdown in the scouting report by Arizona. Why would you go double team on Turner and leave Mills open? It was a reactionary move by the Arizona defense, but they've got to remember who's in what white jersey.
Turner puts Kentucky ahead by one.
Here we see the penetrating move. Turner, as I said, from 15 feet on in, he has quite an arsenal of shots. Great shooter in there, but will not make it from three. Arizona has to remember where Turner is when there's penetration and kickouts. Let Turner open, but make sure Mills is face guarded, as is Padgett.
Miles Simon, named after Miles Davis, the late great musician. His father, Walter, missed playing in a Final Four by one semester. There he is. He played for Utah and entered school there in the fall of 66 after Jack Gardner had taken him to his second straight Final Four in the spring.
Jack Gardner, the only man that's seen every Final Four game that we know of.
Man who took four teams to the Final Four. Kansas State twice. Mills. Hurts the average. Arizona ball. And the under eight timeout. 47,000 on hand in the championship game tied at 20. And there's the Duke of... The Dukes of Hazzard right there. Billy, you said before the game you thought this game might be so wild we'd be talking about double overtime tonight, something crazy like that.
Jim, wasn't it 1957, triple overtime, North Carolina, Kansas, 40 years ago? We'll just have a feeling these two teams could go against each other for a long time and be pretty close.
We'll leave the light on for you.
1-4 offensive set, first time shown by Arizona.
Davison jumper.
Turner may be the leading rebounder in the ball game so far.
He's got four. Rickett. Oh, tough shot. Almost dropped for him. The man who needs 8 points tonight in his 143rd game at Kentucky. Again, the all-time record, 8 points for 1,000.
Well, Jim, remember, he started 9 of his last 10 games his freshman year. Up to that point, he'd been just averaging 5.5 a game. He was all Southeast region, had that 22 points, 11 rebound game against Florida State, and 15-13 against Arkansas. Just had the great run in the NCAA tournament as a freshman.
So Harris sits with his second, Bramlett in.
And remember last year, when he didn't have an opportunity, Jim, to play because he was being redshirted with that knee injury.
He did play the first 5 games, then took the medical redshirt. That helped boost the career game number.
Well, if there's any guy that wanted to get back to the Final Four after what he lost the opportunity last year, it'd be Jarrett. And here's that opportunity for the double team down low.
Over the top.
What do you think of the way they're handling the press? Oh,
they're doing an excellent job when they don't get the ball down so low. One of the reasons for it is Simon's such a great guy to catch the ball.
And look at the soft roller. Simon now with 9 points leading the way.
It's one thing, Jim, to throw those lob passes to a guy that can't catch it, and if he does catch it, can't finish it. Simon can do both.
Whistle away from the ball, and it's one against Kentucky.
Cricket on a push-off, A.J. Bramlett.
Simon, you've said it several times, Billy, during the tournament, is a scorer.
He really is, and I mean that in the fact that he is not a great shooter, but he figures out ways to score. Sometimes even more dangerous to try to guard a guy like that. As we saw with Shamon Williams in the North Carolina game against Arizona, a guy who's a great shooter, but not really be able to create his own shots.
There's Simon creating again. Yeah, he'll go to the line for two more. Near the conclusion of every NCAA tournament game, we have been and we will continue to select a Chevrolet most valuable player of the game from each team. Today, Chevrolet has contributed almost $6.5 million to the scholarship funds of America's colleges and universities. Mercer comes back for Kentucky. He's made only one of four from the field for 3 points. And there's Anthony Epps, who's also one of four from the field, that being a three as well.
Well, well documented that Miles Simon missed the first 11 games this year. He traveled on his own to away games just to support the team. It shows great leadership qualities that he had there. He actually passed the course, Jim, Family Studies 401, which put him over the top and made him eligible. And when they came back, Arizona just didn't take off right away. It took a while to adjust with him in the lineup.
And we study the family for a moment. His sister, Charisse, quite pleased with the two free throws. That gives Arizona the lead, 24-22.
There's that help by Davidson. Somebody open.
Muhammad put it up with the left hand, and Bibby rips away the rebound.
And notice when these guards grab rebounds, they can start to break with the dribble.
Under 6 minutes to go, first half. Dickerson, three-point shot, big arc, comes up shy.
Probably not a good decision to shoot that one, Jimmy. Wasn't squared up, and when you're having a hard time hitting shots, you want to make sure that you get squared up to the basket, not fade away.
There's no foul. Muhammad with the putback to tie it at 24.
Nasi Muhammad has had some big games in the tournament, 10-10 against Iowa in his best outing.
Man who shed 60 pounds from a year ago after being on the JV team last season.
Every time Kentucky doubles down, Arizona looks to go opposite.
Mercer got him with the arm. He's incredulous, but the whistle. And that will be a one-on-one.
Terrific hands by Muhammad, putting it back up. Throughout the course of the year, Jim, this young man's had some big games. 11-14 against Auburn, 18-12 against Georgia Tech. And there's Mercer questioning the call, but no doubt about it, he got a piece of the arm.
1-1 for Simon, who's already hit 7 of 8 from the line.
Jim, one of the things that jumps out at you about this Arizona team, they have taken 188 more free throws than their opponents coming into this this ball game tonight. So they get to the line often.
This is their 11th attempt coming to Kentucky's only two. ...26-24 Arizona.
Solid screen inside. Epps just couldn't get it.
Cricket
really wants it.
Yeah, he got position, but help underneath, and Arizona bats it away.
There's that quickness of their big man, Bramlett, coming over to help out Davidson. Seen a lot of shots blocked by the weak side defender.
Lob, Davison able to keep it in play, trying to duplicate the Grant Hill play of 91 here at the Dome.
Probably not a very good move there, just up 2 points. You can get a better play than that.
Turner applies. Muhammad put back again. The man from Chicago with 6 off the bench. Simon, and they're going to count the basket and send him to the line.
Yes, they are, Jim. Good call. And there's that Arizona team speed once again going right over the top of Kentucky. You can see Rick Pitino for the first time this year looking out of the floor at a team that can run quicker than his team can. Get back. He hates breakouts. One of the things, the few times you'll really hear him scream in practice in a scrimmage is when a team gets a breakout in a scrimmage game. Muhammad doing a good job getting back, but too late.
Yeah, he was called for the goaltend, the foul on Turner, his second. And Miles Simon back to the line. He has already attempted 10 free throws in the first half. Cameron Mills in. There was one time a Mills who, well, tried to play basketball at both schools. And that's Chris Mills. That's one connection between these two programs.
Yes, he played at Kentucky, then went to Arizona. Actually, he's the only guy in Arizona basketball history has a triple-double.
And Arizona will get the ball back. They'll bring back in Michael Dickerson and Gene Edgerson. This Edgerson fella right here, 33, has really been sensational, Billy. 9 rebounds against North Carolina, which matched his freshman high this year of 9 against Carolina in the opener.
And then from New Orleans.
Same high school as Kerry Kittles. Well,
everybody expected Kittles to be the Final Four, and it wasn't Kittles.
Bibby over Epps. Tough shot.
Two bad shots by Arizona. Well, I mentioned the one by Dickerson. That one really wasn't a good put up by Bibby. Kentucky has not been able to free Ron Mercer yet, coming off of those curl moves of his. He doesn't look quite as quick as he's been in the past.
Mills, 2-point basket. One rolls a two, and on the other side a three. And Tim Higgins steps in and emphatically states it's a two.
Jim, Cameron Mills, let's put this in perspective. He did not score a point. We'll see whether he is right on the line with those feet. Yes, he is, without question. He's over the line by good 4 or 5 inches. He did not score a point in the first 4 games of the year this year for Kentucky.
Got the under 4 timeout. The game is not at 28. Check the field goal percentages. And let me tell you that Saturday, when Arizona shot below 33%, it was their worst shooting performance in 132 games since their opening round loss to Santa Clara back in 93. But they won this time.
Good, hard, two-handed chest pass beats Mills.
Simon thought he had it that time. He was sure that was going to drop.
But Dickerson really ripped off that two-handed chest pass. Mills anticipating it's going to be thrown, but had so much on it that it beat his defense.
Cricket got free, and he'll go back to the line.
That was an outstanding move by Cricket. He recognized what happened. Edgerson was going to try to hedge to help Dickerson on Mercer. You'll see it right here. Edgerson, see, he goes out to help, and when he does, the passer does a terrific job of recognizing it, throws it inside. That's reading the defense. A terrific job by Kentucky all the way around.
Bramlett with his first. And enjoying the game, but would rather be on the sidelines, is Clem Haskins, the coach of the year after a magnificent season for Minnesota. And one of the great moves, he kept his team here, didn't send them home. They're here tonight watching the championship game. Wanted them to get the full experience of the week in Indianapolis.
Jim, and here's one of the things that Kentucky likes to do is press off of made free throws. Good job by Dickerson to come back and help. Shortened up the passing lane.
Terry, and it's swatted away by Muhammad.
Muhammad's really having a fine half. McGlure started, but Muhammad is playing the minutes.
6 points and 7 rebounds for Muhammad.
One block and was credited with that last pass to Cricket. Good backdoor move by Mercer.
Mercer gives it back to Cricket. Missed the lay-in, and Bramlett clears.
Jim, this poor shooting percentage and the fact that Kentucky is not in the foul line has taken away their ability to set up their full court pressure, which really helps Arizona.
Terry, open three, got it.
man who slept in his uniform last night. Jason Terry started that ritual last week at the Southeast Regional before the game against Providence. And he's been wearing that now for almost 24 hours.
Well, I'm sure that everybody in the locker room wants to be near him.
It is. Muhammad Muhammad
having a great half. And again, by scoring, the press gets established. Ederson coming back for the ball. Really not a good ball handler.
Dickerson thought about challenging Epps, now looking for help. Go ahead and put it up. Dickerson struggling again tonight. 1 of 6 from the field.
Jim, one of the things that's hurting Dickerson in this slump is shot selection. He's almost shooting as an afterthought. He was the leading scorer on his team, and he got that way by taking good shots, not bad ones.
Muhammad's the hot one.
Rambler on good defense. Muhammad hustling, but he's really getting tired.
Kentucky by one. 1 minute to go in the half. Simon finds Ederson open, who waits, and then got hit on the arm by Muhammad.
Mills is down over here, Jim. Really took a spill. Ederson just waited for everybody to go by because he knows what a great leaper he is. Good move on his part, but Mills went down hard, and he's still there.
Pacino will come over to assist.
Jim, a little chance here to say something about a championship that took place yesterday. The University of Tennessee, Fathead Summit. She is now 55-11 in the NCAA. She's been to 10 Final Fours, 7 title games. She's won 5 championships. It looks like Emil's really got cut on the chin here.
Here's the reverse angle, Billy.
There's Ederson staying down. Goes up. Let's see what happened. I think
he got hit
after the fact.
No, he got hit by the elbow. Just randomly hit Edgerson's right elbow.
Looks like you'll have to go to the locker room.
You mentioned Tennessee's great repeat last night, winning the women's title for the second straight year. Kentucky and Tennessee were the two champions a year ago, and they met at the White House last May the 20th. They'd like to go back to the Rose Garden.
Jim,
a month or two.
Jim, I'm going to give you something that's kind of interesting. You can see Mills really in some pain there. But of the 4 major championships in basketball and baseball, men and women, the SEC has won the last 5. LSU in baseball, UT women's hoops back-to-back, Florida in football, and Kentucky men's basketball. The SEC has reigned supreme with a chance to go again.
Well, Arizona swim team won the championship.
I should have the 4 major sports.
Oh, no.
Football, basketball, 3 major sports. Football, basketball, and baseball. A lot of people have won other championships.
Ederson steps up and knocks them both down for a 39% free throw shooter. Mighty impressive. So a 20 call, and Lute Olson, who had talked about how sick he was of the negative, the 3 out of 5 first-round losses being emphasized around his team, and they almost, though, had that first-round fatality this year in a game against South Alabama, just to think that they were down with 7 minutes to go in round one with 7 minutes to go, down 10.
Against a team that, coached by Coach Musselman, knows how to handle the ball, use up the clock. It was a terrific comeback. It's a very well-coached team.
50 seconds and a half. Big story here. Mercer has only 3 points.
Well, notice how well Arizona is playing the 3.
Muhammad comes in from the side, and he had another chance. He's missed 2 short ones now. And a last shot to Arizona.
How about this Simon? Does he understand the game or not? I mean, he knew without Lute Olson telling him, we're going to take 1 shot. Normally, he's off and running. Here, he plays it easy. Now, he's got Epps. Let's look at the matchups here. I'd go to Bibby with Mercer on him. Looks like Simon wants to keep it the full route. He's down to 7 seconds. Not a good move.
Block. Cricket. Inbounds. 2 seconds. Epps just flings it. And Arizona. Arizona goes to the locker room with a one-point lead.
Jim, I think it would have been smarter for Simon to give it to Bibby, let Bibby penetrate and come out to Simon.
Lute Olson, he's won a world championship. Now he's looking for a national championship.
Maybe we need to go into that a little more depth later. People wouldn't understand. He did win the world championships back in the days before the NBA was involved. To the likes of a David Robinson as a college player, and Muggsy Bogues and Sean Elliott.
That was 1986. Let's bring in Michelle Tafoya. Michelle?
All right, with Coach Lute Olson, you were concerned about the three-point shot. Their star, Ron Mercer, and the press. So far, you've contained Mercer. You've handled the press. Maybe the new challenge is Nazi Muhammad.
Well, the problem is they've done a great job. When we've been hedging out on that screen, they've released their guy really well and hurt us a little bit, so we've got to make some adjustments on that. But pressure-wise, you know, it's like we work against pressure every day, and I know they're awfully good, but our guys have a lot of confidence in handling it. We just need to, we forced some shots. We've been impatient down there, and we've got to get better looks at the basket.
All right, Coach, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
All right, Jim?
Lute Olson's Arizona Wildcats leading 33-32 at halftime. And CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship will continue after this message and a word from your local station.
CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the NCAA National Championship game is sponsored by UPS, Pizza Hut, Goodyear, and by Visa. CBS Sports presents Pennzoil at the Half, sponsored by Pennzoil, formulated for today's stop-and-go driving. Stop, go, Pennzoil.
State Capitol, beautiful building here in downtown Indianapolis. Arizona leads Kentucky 33-32, and if they're electing somebody right now in Arizona, it'd be Miles Simon. He's come up big tonight. Hi again, everybody. I'm Pat O'Brien. Welcome to Pennzoil at the Half. Joining me again, Clark Kellogg and the coach, Mike Krzyzewski. And let's talk about Kentucky first off, Clark.
Well, one of the things that jumped out at me was the fact that Arizona's able to get to the free throw line 14 times and make 12. Kentucky only took four. The other thing, Arizona doing a tremendous job on Ron Mercer. Mercer only got four shot attempts. He's got to double that in the second half.
And Cameron Mills with that big three, Mike.
Well, when Cameron Mills comes into the game, Pat, he's able to stretch Arizona's defense. Take a look at Cameron Mills circled here, and watch how he's going to move along outside the three-point line. Now watch the ball handler, the guy with the ball right now. Watch him dribble, penetrate, and kick off. And then you're going to see, after he kicks off, you're going to see another dribble penetration, and you kick off again, and there's the open three. And that opens some things up inside for the offensive rebounds and baskets for Kentucky.
And 10 ties and 10 lead changes in a great ball game tonight.
It's really been tight, and we kind of expected that. I don't know if either team is going to pull away, but I really think Kentucky has to find a way to get Ron Mercer off in the second half.
They've been switching guys on Ron Mercer. Dickerson and Terry have tried to wear him down, and they're doing a great job.
All right, when you think Final Four as an NCAA championship, gentlemen, one name comes to mind. The coach made 12 trips to the Final Four in 27 years at UCLA, winning a record, think about it, 10 national championships. And 22 years ago today, he coached his final game, defeating Kentucky for the national championship. And I'm pleased to welcome the legend from Martinsville, Indiana, John Wooden, to our show. And Coach, nice to see you. Does it seem like 22 years?
No, time slips by, and particularly as you get older, it goes faster and faster. But it is nice to be back in Indiana, my home state.
Got a lot of friends here. They've all been waving at you. Well, how much has the game, of course, has changed a lot. What are the changes in your mind to the game of basketball in those years?
Since the time I retired, well, gracious sakes, two rule changes have made quite a difference. The three-point goal, also the clock that they didn't have. I think that's made a main difference. And then the players are so much more athletic. I think the athleticism of the players today is just remarkable. But I think as the players have become better, we've lost a little team play. I think the tendency is to, because they are so good individually, to let them go on their own a little too much, and that's hurt team play a little. But gee, I marvel at the athleticism of them.
Coach, if you could, comment on what you valued most in a player that played under you? What kind of skills were you looking for in a player that you like to see most?
Well, the first thing I always looked for, I wanted a player quicker than the opposition in the particular position. I hope my guards will be quicker than opposing guards, forwards, and postmen. And after that, I wanted them players that would look for the pass first. I wanted the vast majority of our baskets to come at the end of a pass, not the end of a dribble.
Coach, today, a lot of coaches are just happy to get to the Final Four. You almost always won when you went to the Final Four. What kind of mindset did you try to create in your players?
Obviously, anyone that gets to the Final Four, you have to feel pretty good about it, but you would like to go all the way. And if you can just concentrate on the things that got you there. I think in my early years, I didn't do well in tournament when I started out, and I think I wanted it so much that I overworked them, both physically and mentally. And finally, when I got over that, I said it took me a long time to learn, but once I got it, I had it down pretty good.
Coach, I think
good. Yeah, I would say you had it pretty good.
I think his real question was, how can he win
That's
10
right.
championships? But do you think you could dominate today, Coach?
I didn't understand.
Do you think you could dominate the game today like you did?
No. I was at the right time at the right place. I've been blessed. The Lord's blessed me very much.
All right. What about tonight's game? What do you see in tonight's game?
Oh, it's a great game. I enjoyed it. It's what a championship game should be. A real tight, and it's real good. I've been impressed with the way that Arizona has been able to counter the pressure from Kentucky very well, and they have done an excellent job on Mercer. There's no question about it, and that's hurt Kentucky to some extent. But it's anybody's game, and that's just the way it should be.
You know, everybody knows the coach as the Wizard of Westwood, but I bet you guys didn't know that he was once known as the Indiana Rubber Man. Did you know that? Why was that?
Well, there were those who said I bounced up a lot when I got down to the floor.
Still got a bounce in your step, too, Coach. Nice to see you. Always a pleasure to have you here. Thank you, Pat.
Thank you, Clark. And good Mike. Coach. Nice to see you.
That was great. Thank you. Coming up, we'll send you courtside back to Jim Nance and Billy Packer for the second half. Thanks for watching Pennzoil at the Half. Enjoy the second half here on CBS.
Pennzoil at the Half was sponsored by Pennzoil, formulated for today's stop-and-go driving. Stop, go, Pennzoil.
The midterm report here from
you. Well, close game. We talked about Kentucky pressure. Let's take a look. 7 turnovers, 5 assists. Kentucky only 10 points off turnovers. Arizona doing a good job there. Simon says, and look at what Simon says. 15 points to 3 for Mercer, all Arizona. In defense, 3-point shooting. Both teams doing a fairly good job out there. They can't afford to leave guys alone. Field goal shooting percentage still way down. That's a Mexican standoff. Arizona up by 1.
CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the NCAA Basketball Championship will continue after this message and a word from your local station. Simon leading the way with 15, and Billy, Kentucky's bench has scored 19 of its 32 points.
And Jim, 11 of their 22 rebounds. So Nazi Muhammad particularly has 7 rebounds, 8 points. Terrific job.
And look at this, 10 ties, 10 lead changes.
Very even basketball game for some different reasons. And Miles Simon has been the guy, as I mentioned on that point, Simon says, and he has spoken in his first half.
This man spoke in the second half Saturday against North Carolina. Hits 5 threes in the second stanza. Mike Bibby.
Double teaming out of this.
Hands of Turner, but he got a piece of the arm. Kentucky had trailed in the tournament in the second half a total of 25 seconds prior to tonight. 15 seconds trailing by a point to Iowa in the second round, and for 10 seconds last Saturday night against Minnesota.
Mills has to come in, and that's the third foul on Turner. Very important. Mills nowhere near the defender. Try to go lob over the top.
Padgett reached in and knocked it away.
So that means that Epps becomes the primary ball handler, with Turner sitting down. Changes things a lot for Kentucky.
He handled that job for about the first 30 games of the season. Here's Padgett, his favorite spot to mention. All there this time. They're set up for a press.
You don't see that often, Jim. You're talking about a very good outside shooter. Not guarded at all. Here's the press. Bibby comes back to it.
Ramblin' Simon, long. Oh, he hit the rim.
It was too good a pass.
Well, that's why he's a scorer,
or too bad a shot.
He's such a scorer, he can't even pass without almost making it. Kentucky ball.
And, Jim, that was a very easy play for 2 points for Arizona. It didn't have to be that good a lob. Just a direct two-handed pass, Davison would have put it away. Dickerson's having his problems offensively, but he is really shadowing Mercer. That's a game within itself, watching those two chase each other around the floor.
Mercer got free off the McGlure screen, and Kentucky moves ahead.
First time Mercer's been able to rub off that screen and get free.
That was his first field goal in over 15 minutes on the clock. Dickerson, Bramlett can follow. Blocked by McGlure.
Kentucky getting great play out of their double centers, Muhammad and McGlure.
Mills, three. Rolls out, and a push against Arizona.
Two wide open threes for Kentucky. Mills misses one, Padgett the other. You won't see that often.
They gave Mills at halftime three stitches in his chin after that elbow, flying elbow he was.
How about this substitution, Jim? Arizona puts down all three now. This is for an instructional set by Lute Olson, not for a rest.
Mills, Bramlett picked up his second a moment ago, and Edgerson picks up the board.
Just a mini clinic by Lute Olson with his three frontline players.
Bibby, oh, he loves the second half.
And he loves that side of the floor.
Arizona by two.
Bibby shooting right under 40% for three on the year. We talked about his opening game against North Carolina. Came up big, showed he was going to have a presence in the air.
Mills, a two.
Arizona is so quick, Kentucky really pulls off the press quite a bit.
Simon, good save. Good move by Miles Simon.
Simon knew what he was going to do, Jim, before he caught the ball. He had his mind set up. It was an excellent offensive play.
And
he
a 20. Smart. 20 called by Kentucky. Kentucky, which has won its last 11 NCAA tournament games.
Jim, here we see the end of that basket, but we're watching right at what Simon had in mind. Before he caught the ball, he froze the defense of Kentucky. They thought he was going to catch and pass. He split the middle. He's done it twice tonight.
Kentucky team, Billy, used 11 different starting lineups this season. You look at their numbers with Derek Anderson out. It's so great to see him shoot the two technicals on Saturday. But you have the 18-point average of Mercer. And then the next eight players all average between 5 and 9 points, everyone understanding their role in this Pitino system.
You know, those stats are kind of funny in this respect. Mercer was right at 18 when Anderson went down, and he's still at 18.
Mercer! Basket interference on McGlure.
It was on the rim.
I think it was on the way down, too. I think it was going to drop for a basket.
Now, here's a case where Mercer may be a little tired, Jim. He'd normally be way up above that rim on that putback. Excellent stutter dribble by Bibby.
Loose ball, and Mercer bounced it off the Arizona player, Bibby.
Here we see the tip, ball on the cylinder, and everybody wanting to become an official there.
Hold on now, they're going to call a foul on
Simon.
The Wildcats. Nope, we'll see.
Yeah, it's going to be on Simon. He banged Mercer, who beat him with the first step.
That's the first foul he's committed. That's why I was a little startled, Billy, in the last 115 minutes of playing time.
I said he was a smart basketball player.
It goes back to the first half of the Kansas game in the Sweet 16 round.
To play good, solid defense and not foul is what every coach loves. And he has played solid deep. back screen for Mercer. He's just not as quick as normal.
Rickett, and that pass, tough one for Mercer to field.
Now remember, Mercer played 34 grueling minutes against Minnesota, and the minutes that he sat down was not to rest, it was to recover from the cramps. So I think that he is quite a bit beyond, below what he normally shows with quickness.
Dickerson blocked by McGlure. And last touch by Mercer. We've got the under 16 timeout. Kentucky will come out of the break with Nazi Muhammad, their first half star. There's a 1-point lead at the intermission. It's now 2. Arizona trying to continue the Cinderella ride.
Exceptional athletic ability, razor-sharp reflexes, and excellent TV reception.
Catch Cosby, CBS Monday.
He dug from Cosby. How about Michael Dickerson tonight? He's 1 of 8. He's missed his last 5, but he has been playing defensively quite a game against Mercer.
Jim, he was only 1 for 10 on Saturday. There's the double down. Let's see if it'll go opposite. Bibby didn't get himself in position.
5 on the shot clock here.
Bibby's got to come to the ball now and try to make a move off the dribble. Here's going to be the screen by Harris.
And Lute wants the 20. He wants to
set up a play.
Absolutely, with only 5 on the shot clock.
He's going to put Miles Simon back in the game.
Billy, let's talk about what you've seen so far. This team from Arizona, just tireless, fearless, and certainly unintimidated by the national champions who are going for back-to-back.
They are that, Jim, and let's face it, when you beat 2 number 1 seeds like Kansas and North Carolina, you have no reason to be afraid of anybody, and I think we have to go back to the fact that this team would not be a fifth-place team in the Pac-10, nor have the losses that they had if they would have been at full strength at the start of the year. Plus, it's a very young team, so it's come on strong. How about that move, guy?
Good shot.
Lute Olson.
How about that?
Special
20?
Kudos. There's a special 20-second timeout. You set up the play you want. Great coaching move.
And you give them their biggest lead of the second half. They led it by 6 at one time in the first. It's now 4. And off the steal, they're looking for more. Simon in traffic. Followed up by Harris.
And there's the team speed. Harris, Edgerson, Davison, Bramlett, all their big guys can really fly.
And Kentucky wants to come back with a 20 of its own.
Jim, I think fatigue is setting in a little bit for Kentucky now. That Minnesota game, we can't say enough about how brutal the combat was in that game. And here's that great 20-second timeout that Lute Olson used to set up the play for Simon, his star for the night. And watch the big guys run on this play. Edgerson coming back from behind. Keeps it alive. Harris, he's right there as well. We're talking about the big guys running.
Dino will remind his team the mantra he's had all season. Poor, hungry, driven. Trying to get this team.
I was looking over at the bench, and I'm wondering, how long is Rick Pitino going to go before he puts Turner back in? And just as my mind was thinking, boom, here comes Turner in the game. Rick Pitino can't wait much longer.
Mercer to Brickett. Good control of the ball by Brickett. So his first option is going to be blocked, and Harris calls a timeout.
Lute Olson did not want to have to use a timeout to get the ball inbounds.
And it's a 20. So we've had 3 20s here, and just about a minute of action or less.
Well, the first one was a coach's 20 to set up a good play. That was an outstanding play by Prickett, hesitating with the ball. Nice dump down inside by Mercer. Good teamwork.
Prickett, who last year watched the championship game at the Meadowlands, sitting with the Pep fan as he set out the year with that medical red shirt. He wasn't even allowed to get down on the floor and celebrate. Security guard wouldn't let him. Finally, a member of the athletic department spotted him, brought him down to join the jubilation, celebration. Boy, through that pressure, three-way pressure.
Just great dribbling work by Bibby.
Look at the pass. Over to Terry. Again, pushing the boards and on the back.
I think they're
Kentucky. It's going against Kentucky.
Muhammad felt that he was pushed under the basket and didn't get the call.
Call on Prickett, his second. Second team foul. Harris in trouble. And Prickett tried to bounce it off his leg. Bibby in the right spot.
That is the second time that Kentucky has created a turnover. Arizona's been able to then recapture the ball and score.
44-38 Arizona, 14 minutes remaining.
Turner back in the game. Let's see if he can get the ball in his hands off and start penetrating and kicking out.
Going up the other way. Call against Kentucky.
That's Prickett trying to set a screen to get Mercer free. But, Jim, the reason that the screens are having to be set the way they are is Mercer is not as blazing quick as he normally is. And you can see the hands by Prickett. Simon trying to come over the top. The call is made.
That's the third on Prickett, and Mercer's going to have to get accustomed to playing two games in three nights next year.
Absolutely.
Again, this is tough. Wait till you have to play 82.
Again, watch Bibby. Sometimes when he realizes the pass is not there, he dribbles through. Other times when he sees it there, he goes over the top. For a freshman, he understands what to do.
Davison. Bramlett had it, knocked loose. Davison, this team can jump and they're still so fresh with the legs
and quick to the ball. We saw that in the North Carolina game. We saw that in the Kansas game. Their big men can fly.
Never touch the rim. Two on a shot clock and a whistle.
Foul on Padgett.
What a break, because they were in no position to shoot a shot and only two on the shot clock. They had not hit the rim with the Davison air ball.
You think Bibby didn't see that shot clock and he split the double team? Watch Bibby. He sees the shot clock right there. Now he splits the double team. Terrific move on his part.
Third on Padgett. Padgett with three, Prickett with three, but Padgett makes the steal.
Kentucky fans getting a little bit agitated here. They've got their 2-point guards in the game and see if they can free up Mercer. Terry's on him. Mercer can shoot over him.
This one's going against Jason Terry. But just the third team foul against Arizona.
Watch the big men for Arizona. Every time a screen is set, the big men hedge out. Now, Bramlett wasn't there that time, and that's what probably caused Terry to get that foul.
Mercer got stuck. Muhammad, wow, right with two players draped on him. And a whistle.
Wait a minute.
We got the shot clock.
Are they going to wave the basket? We had the shot clock on the other end was stopped at 20 seconds.
I just think it had to reset after the made basket. Higgins saw it quickly. Oh, the basket counts.
The whistle was blown after the basket then.
Yes, clearly. Well, they've had a couple of problems with it tonight. And Kentucky now gets a chance to get all set in its press, down four.
Jim, since 1981, five teams have reached the championship game with nine or more losses. Let me tell you something surprising. Indiana won in 81, North Carolina State won in 83, Villanova won in 85, and Kansas won in 88. Arizona has nine or more losses.
Well, they call an official timeout. They're going to actually replace the shot clock. Word we've heard from the other side of the floor.
You start talking about replacing, Jim. Do you mean they're going to physically come up and take it down?
Bob Dekus, our producer, has received that word. That would take quite a while. All right, now they've just reset it. That can't go to that extreme. Put a new computer unit in to run the shot clock. So we're back to play. Swinging it over to Simon. Oh, we're both banking home like Bibby did Saturday.
There's Bramlett keeping it alive, but he couldn't get it back out.
Kentucky ball.
You notice everybody from Arizona that time, Jim, stayed out on the perimeter. Nobody came back to help A.J. Bramlett out. When you've got a teammate in duress, you've got to go meet the ball.
12:30 remaining. back of the rim, and Bibby smothers the ball.
Semi-break coming up, looking for him to rotate the ball quickly.
A mismatch, Muhammad on Terry. Very tough shot.
He could have got a much better one than that, Jim, with that mismatch. Terrific penetrator. Turner, an all-American high school player out of Boston, is high in high school to tell you whether or not he can score with 62 points. He's found his role now at Kentucky. And here you'll see a great dribble. Takes it inside, puts it up with the right hand. He can go either way. Nazi Muhammad sits down. McGuire in, and Rick Pitino getting great play out of that combination center position.
Bramlett picked up his third. Turner, the only time in his Kentucky career he didn't get into a game was last year's title game.
See how Bibby took that ball to the center of the court instead of keeping it on the sidelines where Kentucky loves to trap.
Double up on Bramlett.
Bramlett's taking too much time to get the ball over.
Davison underneath charge.
Jim, for the first time, the Arizona players getting a little bit frustrated. A good sign for Rick Pitino's team.
Under 12 timeout at Indianapolis.
The National Championship game is sponsored by Pontiac Grand Prix, Budweiser, Phillips Magnavox, and by AT&T.
This has really been just a fantastic host city to the national championship and Final Four, Indianapolis. Aerial shots brought to you by Goodyear, Circle City, Indianapolis. Arizona watching the Kentucky bench come in big with 25, while the starters have been held to 17. Mercer with only 5, their top man, who averages 18 a game.
Jim, that bench is shooting 50%, the starters 29%. Arizona doing a great job out there guarding against the perimeter jump shot.
Yes, he's missed 6 in a row, but tipped up and in by Mercer.
Very dangerous guy in the offensive glass.
Come back from 6 down to tie it at 44. Lob this time, Davison retrieves. There's Turner with a great block. And Mercer comes out of the pack. Kentucky can regain the lead.
How about Turner? Not only with his rebounding tonight, but that was a sensational block against one of the best leapers in college ball.
Stolen back by Terry. To Simon, slicing in for 2. 21 for Simon.
That was a very important basket for Arizona. They were really on the ropes here. Even though the score doesn't show it, you can see some cracks.
Yeah, they've given up 6 unanswered. Mercer's pass deflected, but McGlure's there.
Why did they double down on McGlure, knowing that they're good jump shooters outside?
Like Padgett. Mercer. Oh, how did it go? The shot of the night by Ron Mercer.
He is just gutting it through tonight. He does not have his normal legs. He's really tired, but he's showing what an All-American player's got to do. He was waiting for the shot to be blocked, put it up on the hesitation reverse.
And he got the 4th on Bramlett.
He really never did eye up the rim, Jim. He just was able to go ahead and do this out of instinct. See him right here? He's not even looking at the rim. Kentucky now making that change. Muhammad for McGlure. Those two guys have really played a key role for Kentucky tonight, with Mercer a little bit off in his game.
Mercer can give them the lead. Pitino says he has the potential to be one of the greatest. The only player who scored in last year's final for this Kentucky team that's on the floor tonight. He had 20 in the final against Syracuse as a freshman.
Was the MVP of the game, right, Jim?
That's Tony
Not Felton. Of the tournament, but of the game.
Tony Delk had the seven threes in the game. The Gypsy on hand. Simon fouls out into the arms of Harris, and he is hacked. Harris making some plays off the bench.
Both teams getting incredible play, particularly down inside with Harris off the bench, making up for Bramlett's foul trouble right now. Ederson did a good job, and of course we've mentioned time and again McGlure and Muhammad.
Mills with his first 15 foul. Harris to shoot two.
Harris last year basically spent the year backing up Ben Davis, the outstanding rebounder and scorer, and not a good free throw shooter, but he banked it. Maybe that's in the...
They do that a lot.
Yeah, that's exactly what happened for Bibby, only it was a jump shot at that same basket Saturday.
Wow, the two puts Arizona back in front by one, and we've moved inside the 10-minute mark.
Simon on Turner.
Muhammad, he'll shoot free throws. Harris fouled him.
Little drop step by Muhammad.
Three on Harris.
Going down inside, I mentioned Muhammad, and you don't think about this until you look at the Kentucky stats. And as I mentioned, he's had big games. Double-doubles against Ohio State, Georgia Tech, and Auburn. Young man who's worked so hard to put himself in the physical condition to be a player.
I think if Kentucky wins, Pitino might win the second straight Sportsman of the Year award in the state of Kentucky. Last year, after winning the national title, he was able to squeeze past the competition on a statewide vote of sports writers. Ederson needs some help, but he calls the timeout.
Remember in the first half, he got caught in there and didn't call the timeout and turn it over, so he gets a quick 20.
That's a 20-second timeout. They're going to call it a full. At first, they wanted the 20. Now they'll take the full. We'll be back. By the way, Arizona had to take a full because they're out of 20s. They have only one full timeout left. I was going to say, Billy, that he just edged out W.T. Young for Sportsman of the Year in the state of Kentucky, who was the owner of Grindstone, the horse that won the Derby. Got to win a championship to win that honor in the Commonwealth.
There's the press, and a great job by Simon to hit over the top.
Dickerson waits for the rest of the team.
Really kind of uncomfortable offensively, isn't he, Jim?
He's just so uncertain after missing early.
He's had five 30-point games and is hesitant on the offensive end because he just has lost confidence there, and there is another turnover. You really feel momentum, even though Kentucky is behind, momentum going their way.
You feel like Arizona's starting to get out of sync.
Yeah, in the half-court offense, Arizona really hasn't executed well at all in the last 4 or 5 minutes.
Mercer, three-pointer, chases it down.
I thought he was out of bounds.
Moved his feet pretty quick. Epps, boy, breaks a cold streak. The other end, Dickerson, never looking for a shot.
Exactly. You can see, very hesitant. I mean, normally a guy that's a leading scorer would have taken that ball and gone right to the hoop.
Harris left open to tie it with a jam.
Baked down defensively by Kentucky. Gave up an easy basket there just when Arizona needed it.
50-50 with 8:30 remaining.
Jim, you mentioned Kansas. Wasn't it 50-50 Oklahoma at halftime back in 1988?
The 50th Final Four.
That's right.
Padgett thought he would take it. Step in for two instead, and Kentucky 52-50.
Ederson really not comfortable out there guarding a man that puts the ball on the floor.
Only two starters on the floor for Arizona. That's Dickerson and Simon. So Bibby's out. Bramlett with the four and Davison out. Simon over Muhammad.
Always finds a way to help his team. Never looks tired.
Mercer dumps it. Padgett. Two in a row.
That's a hard shot to make because Padgett realized at the last minute a man was coming from behind him. Still kept his composure.
Look at Terry take off. Wanted a walk on the Kentucky end. Simon squeezing, and they'll call him for traveling.
Huge call there.
Took away the basket, of course. He thought they were going to get the whistle for a three-point opportunity.
Again, though, Jim, you really sense a breakdown in Arizona's team. Everything now has become one-on-one by Simon. It is not the team offense we saw when they were executing smoothly to get the lead.
No, no, says Miles Simon. They brought in Bibby. I had a little punch, they hope. 16 ties, 15 lead changes.
Mercer trying to post up down inside on Terry.
Gotcha. And Bibby comes in with the trees to get the rebound. Bibby with cricket on him. Now a switch.
Good pivot by Simon to get away from that defense.
Terry, three-point shot. Oh, what a big one.
Over Padgett. That was like an air ball, Jim. He had to put a little extra arch on it just to get it over the big man.
Puts Arizona ahead, 55-54.
Terry's got the freshest legs of anybody out there because he hadn't played the minutes. He's on Mercer. They've got to get Mercer the ball down low.
Kentucky ball. I know what you were thinking. You were about to question this shot selection.
Well, it was good defense. Padgett was lucky he didn't fall into Terry to foul him on the three.
Bennett Davison comes back. Arizona's biggest lead, six. Kentucky, two.
Simon goes out. In a way, Jim, this may help Arizona because he's been the guy had to do everything one-on-one. Let's see if Arizona gets back in an offense trying to go inside some.
Maybe he was mad he wasn't there. He thought, I should have stolen that one. Just a fraction late. Five on the shot clock. Padgett has to shoot it. Cricket.
Oh, Harris on the back.
Harris. Harris over the back. And that will put Cricket on the line, 1-1.
That's about as good as you can play defense if you're Arizona going down. Turner couldn't get the shot off. Good adjustment, and then all of a sudden Harris goes up, goes right over Prickett's back.
Four on Harris and four on Bramlett, who still sits. 1-1 for Prickett. If he makes them both, he'll have his career 1,000. Harris pulls it down.
Notice how Kentucky can test those rebounds.
Foul on Kentucky.
Going to be on Mercer. On a reach.
Won't be a shooting situation. Only the sixth team foul. Second on Mercer.
One of the reasons it's so tough, Jimmy, to break. Here we see some foul trouble right here.
Sixth foul.
A.J. Bramlett probably being the one, the most serious guy sitting on the bench. Good change.
Cricket committed the foul, and that will put him on the line 1-1.
If you go back and review the tapes of this game, and you'll say, well, why didn't other teams do that against Kentucky? Throw the ball over the top and beat the press that way. The reason was they didn't have guys that were this quick to catch the ball.
Cricket out Cricket. With four. And you Rick see? Pitino.
And what he's talking about is beating men to the spot. But again, Arizona can get there quicker than you can.
Dickerson's first point since 12:42 remained in the first half.
And Jim, one of the things with the little lack of confidence that Dickerson has, you can tell a scorer, and he has been the leading scorer, who doesn't get to the foul line, it's a good indication he's lost some confidence. He's only averaging 12 points a game in the NCAA tournament, averaged over 19 a game during the regular season.
And again, five games over 30, or a minimum of 30. All Pac-10 first team, but 3 points ahead now. Dickerson puts Arizona with 5:48 remaining. Muhammad can't say enough about this night.
Now, Bramlett is sitting. With five to go, you think Lute Olson's got to bring him back now and take the chance.
Fourth on Padgett. Four on Cricket, four on Padgett.
I think we'll see.
I'm going to call it on Mercer. Padgett even had raised his hand, so that's the third on Mercer.
Jim, I think we're going to see Bramlett back in the ball game to put a stop to what Kentucky probably wants to do, is to go down inside to Muhammad realizing that he's got so much size on Harris. You can see Lute Olson's strategy is to keep Simon on the bench to be rested, to go down for the stretch drive offensively. But he may need Bramlett in there for defense.
So a 1-1 coming from Mike Bibby.
Bibby, of course, made the two biggest free throws of his life in the Kansas game to seal things up.
Well, put him up three. Kansas still had the 3 3-point attempts.
Well, if he doesn't hit any, they don't even have to go for the three.
So the all-time high school scorer in the state of Arizona, the first freshman to start since Sean Elliott at Arizona. There's Cameron Mills for Epps.
And I'm sure that Rick Pitino is only going to sit Epps down just for a few seconds because he's going to want it back in there for defense.
There it is. We'll get one more. And Sean Elliott's here. A lot of the former Arizona players came back to show their support. Sean Elliott.
Well, in 88, when they lost to Oklahoma, Elliott had a 31-11.
Virginia Bibby, mother, saluting the two free throws that puts them back 59-56, three-point lead. Elliott here along with Kerr, Buechler. Padgett ties it. He's really becoming the player here to keep Kentucky in it.
See how Bibby keeps the ball in the center of the court, Jim. Really takes away that opportunity to steal.
Mercer, Terry right back with the pick.
There's that team quickness again.
Bibby open three in Arizona. 62-59.
Jim, three times Kentucky has had the numbers and an opportunity to score. Arizona has intercepted the ball and been able to come right back and score themselves.
Under 5 minutes remaining. Padgett looking for the tie. Oh, Scott Padgett, please.
And you know what's happening? Nazi Muhammad is such a problem, as Davison went in to help out. Left Padgett at the top of the key.
62 all, 4:30 to go. Davison, baseline, blocked by Turner. They got it back.
And a foul from behind? Yes, it will be.
On Muhammad.
Tremendous will on the part of both of these teams tonight. Battling with everything they've got. There's Turner goes up. I thought he committed a foul, but look at the quickness of Davison. They are so quick to the ball. Here was the foul. I thought it was a foul anyway. Davison gets his own, makes up for it.
So the son of a San Francisco cable car operator, dad retired recently after 30 years, gives Arizona the 65-62 advantage.
Lute Olson.
Edgerson in.
Really playing tough cards right now with Bramlett on that bench, and he's saying, as long as I've got the lead, I'm going to try to keep my good guys fresh to the end.
Foul outside on Edgerson. And that'll send Padgett to the line for a 1-1.
Jim, we're talking about Padgett coming up big. As a freshman, he played 14 games. He averaged 4 minutes a game, scored 2 points and 1.2 rebounds. Last year, as we know, a redshirt academically, looked like he would have no chance to even become part of the Kentucky's program, and now here he is stepping up as a big star.
Shoot one more. He failed a couple of classes in the spring of 95 and had to end up watching last year's championship game at home on television. Now leads the team academically, even made the dean's list in the fall. And I'll tell you what, all kinds of lists he's making tonight. His parents certainly proud with the performance in the second half. Bibby in trouble. Edgerson ahead. They got 3-on-1. Terry thinking about it. Edgerson on the floor. Stripped away. And Turner comes out with it. Kentucky can take the lead back.
Got Padgett open. He wants the jumper. Boy, that was just terrific defensive recovery by Arizona, because Kentucky runs as well as anybody. Arizona somehow got back.
65-64, Arizona.
You can watch these teams play for days. You know what? They just are so evenly matched.
Oh, it went in and out. Muhammad can't find it. And off the rim, he'll shoot two. Eckerson with his second personal. Paget now has got the feel where you expect every shot to go in.
Again, you see that Kentucky's wisely going to him. And again, Jim, there is no question in my mind that Ron Mercer is probably at about 80% quickness-wise. He's not able to come to the ball, and Paget has really stepped up.
They brought back A.J. Bramlett with the four fouls.
And he's rested, but he does have four fouls on him, Jim.
And Cricket also. He has four fouls.
Rick Pitino making a gutsy coaching move. He's going to put Paget down to let him be rested for the final 2 minutes.
54% free throw shooter. He shoot two. Man, when he was recruited by Rick Pitino, watched him in high school, said he couldn't even get past midcourt up and down the floor. He was out of shape.
And give credit to Kentucky's JV program, where he had an opportunity, instead of sitting the bench, to go ahead and play in actual game condition.
Look at him. Gets his own miss. Charge on Muhammad.
Nobody blocking out the shooter. And you've got to block out a shooter that's only shooting 51%, particularly one that can rebound.
We got the under four TV timeout. Paget with 15, 12 in the second half, keeping Kentucky in it. Arizona leads by one, and as you digest these numbers, consider this. Kentucky this year 35-0 when leading with 5 minutes to play, but 0-4 when trailing with 5 minutes to play. They trailed tonight at that point, and they trail with 3.5 remaining.
Well, they've only lost four games, one of them being right on this court in overtime to Clemson.
Simon rejected by Paget, but back to Bibby.
Wow!
Fires the three. Bramlett, they'll get a third try. Big break for Arizona.
Have to question why Bibby took it. Davison wide open.
He's up short on the jump shot.
That's a tough sequence for Arizona. They had a lot of good chances. Rick Pitino has Paget back in there after taking that little rest.
Bibby inside. One player yelled, same team. And inside 3 minutes with a one-point lead.
Good hedge move and a double team, but Simon breaks it.
Overshot, but Bibby runs it down, and Turner bumped him.
That's his fourth.
Bibby with seven rebounds, and he'll shoot two. It's double bonus on each side.
Again, we get back to that quickness to the ball. Team quickness by Arizona, excellent.
You saw Coach Wooden at halftime. He had a guard named Henry Bibby. Mike Bibby's father back in 70 through 72 seasons. They won titles all 3 years. Coach Wooden told Henry that he's much better than you were,
you know,
your son.
Funny you bring that up. I was with both of them yesterday when Henry asked that question of Coach Wooden at the NABC banquet. Coach said, I believe he's a little better player. That's always kind of humbling.
No one's ever going to second guess Coach Wooden. Even play a minute last year's title game, and now penetrates with a big shot with 2:15 remaining.
But he's going to have to be careful on defense, Jim, because he's got four fouls, and there is a call.
A charge. Is it a charge?
Yes.
Bibby? Yes.
Paget. Bibby gave up the ball, and Paget stayed with it. Excellent piece of coaching. The Bibby comes down. Paget was there. He established position. Bibby was in the air.
And Paget, again, double bonus on each side. He'll shoot two and can give Kentucky the lead with 2:09 remaining.
The last five national champs have been number one seeds.
And Arizona's trying to do something that's never been done, and that's to defeat three number one seeds on the way to the championship. He can't do any better than that. That becomes now, with that made free throw, our 19th tie. And our 17th lead change.
What happened here? Well, he's got a cut.
Paget has a cut. Teddy Valentine spotted it.
Boy, he's got the eyes, doesn't he, to see that? Well, he is bleeding down on the elbow. He will have to come out of the ball game. And Rick Pitino, remember, he put Paget down just to take that little bit of rest, Jim. and it became very effective. Now he's going to get a rest, but Rick Pitino like to take some time here to get him back in. He'll have to wait for the first dead ball. He cannot come right back in now.
McClure is the substitution.
And not bad, because McClure will be in there on the defensive end of the floor. Libby looks one way, throws the other.
2 minutes remaining. The young Arizona Wildcats down one. Simon in the lane, puts it back in front.
He changes off that catch all the time. Kentucky rushes at him, and he goes right back inside, and now a 20. Do they still have a 20?
I don't think they do. I think they're out of 20s. And Timmy Higgins notifies them. They're out of 20, so they have to take the full with 1:45 remaining. Arizona by one. Jim Nance, Billy Packer, with what has been a blockbuster championship game. The largest lead was 6 by Arizona. Each team with 2 players saddled with 4. Joanne Pitino and Bobby Olson, wife of 43 years. Kentucky down one with possession.
Pageant on the pick and roll, step out looking for the jump shot.
Never touched anyone from Arizona.
And a beautiful move by Rick Pitino. Hey, a mistake has been made. He calms his team down immediately. Sets up the press. These two coaches have had an outstanding game. Not only their game plans, but the way they've directed their teams. Substitution patterns.
Turner knocked it out.
How good a defensive player is Turner?
He's been in the right place so many times tonight defensively.
Kentucky set all-time team steal records this year. Simon's open.
Simon with Prickett coming in on him.
Oh, that's intentional.
It's intentional. He'll shoot two, and Arizona will have possession.
That was a breakdown by Kentucky on the press. You'll see the breakdown. Simon pulls away. Prickett had no chance to make the block. Should have let him go for the uncontested layup. He comes from behind. No question about the call.
And Prickett has fouled out in his final game at Kentucky.
And Arizona will get 2, Jim, here, and the ball out of bounds.
Prickett's mom and dad, his father a coal miner back in West Virginia. Their son only the second Kentucky player ever to play in 3 Final Fours. Walter Hirsch had done it some 45 years ago.
Mr. Basketball in the state of West Virginia.
Now Miles Simon to shoot 2. 9 of 11 tonight at the line.
Harder to make them, Jim, when you're on the line and there are no people standing around.
Kid who came to 6 Final Fours as a fan. Took it all in, he said. The Friday practices, missed nothing. Dreamed about being on this stage as a player. It's 1 of 2. Arizona ball, 70-68, Arizona.
You know what's interesting? Who's not on the board? He just comes back in now is Dickerson.
Been a lot of number 23s who have hit the game-winning shot at championship games. Yeah. A guy named Jordan, 15 years ago this past Saturday. Keith Smart.
Good screening by Arizona.
Tough pass, and Epps picked it off.
Nobody came back to the ball.
2 to tie, 3 for the lead.
Dickerson's on Padgett. Simon on Mercer. Little penetration by Turner. They're trying to get Padgett out for a jump shot. It's a double, triple screen.
Turner drives. Turner, too strong. Ball on the floor. Bibby comes out with it. And he's fouled. Will head to the line for 2.
Turner got the shot he wanted, Jim, on the drive. There was a clear out for him. He normally is going to put that shot away. You see the drive. He is really good at that shot. Put it up soft.
And Turner fouls out.
Huge play here. He reached back in. He'd like to have that shot back. He slapped it to the floor when he missed it.
Wayne Turner with his 5th.
Libby goes to the line. Libby shoots under 70%, but big in the key spots. Now, look, he's staying off that foul line. This is a very smart thing to do. Don't go on that line while the referees are talking. You can start to tighten up. Now he moves a little bit to it. You want to get in your normal motion.
The Bibby family embraced. It can hardly stand it. He'll shoot two.
Now Bibby does a smart thing again. He walks off the line while the controversy taking place here.
So Kentucky loses Prickett and Turner to fouls. To play.
Go for two here. Try to get Mercer in the action on a rub. Here he comes.
Mercer three.
Got it!
Down to one.
That's execution for you there. Bibby and Simon, they seem to have a wavelength, don't they? When he breaks it on the dribble, Simon's always waiting.
15-second differential on the shot clock to the game clock.
Kentucky should not foul here. It's a bad matchup for Kentucky, though, because you have your shooter, Padgett, guarding the best penetrator, which is not his forte.
But decisions must be going through the freshman's mind. He starts the dribble at eight. Now drives in, dishes. Davison banks it home.
That was a bad matchup for Kentucky.
Kentucky needs a three to tie. Epps fires it. Got it. Game's tied at 74.
Here comes Simon and Bibby now. Going to try to attack the press.
Simon drives. Simon shoots. No call. Padgett with the rebound.
Perry with a steal.
Not in time. They ruled off the shot. We're going to overtime. And Mr. Packer, you're quite prophetic. Indescribable from Indianapolis.
Beat Providence to make it here. At the Final Four, to the Final Four, with an overtime win against Providence.
And Jim, one of the key things now is, think of it, Turner is on the bench with five fouls.
Prickett also
is on the bench with five fouls, so Arizona has a slight advantage there.
Padgett has four. Bramlett with four on the side for Arizona.
Both teams get an extra timeout.
Bibby retrieves.
Pushes that ball up court.
Kind of interesting. Each team had a timeout in regulation. Arizona didn't take one for the final shot. Then off the rebound, Kentucky didn't call one. Just about 2 seconds to go. Davison working inside, and McClure hacked him.
I love the composure of Simon and Bibby on the floor. They're almost connected by a cord. Seems like when Bibby breaks the press, Simon always seems to be open.
Third on McClure, who will head out. Muhammad in.
Let's see if Kentucky, one time down the floor, Jim, tries to go into Muhammad to get Brantlett off, out of the ball game with four fouls to try to balance his foul trouble up a little bit. I wouldn't be a bit surprised to see. That's why Muhammad came in for McClure.
Davison, who was playing junior college ball a year ago.
Best junior college player in America.
Hits them both.
Check the offensive set now for Kentucky. See if they try to go down inside to Muhammad. Mercer off. Muhammad not looking for the ball. Here he is.
Kentucky with only two starters on the floor. That's Epps and Mercer. Epps to Muhammad. Boy, that was a great pass. Epps was stuck for a moment, and he found Muhammad open.
Well, it wasn't exactly how I thought they would try to get the ball inside. Who are they calling that foul?
Might be
on?
Bramlett.
If it is, it works out perfectly for Rick Pitino.
It is. It's Bramlett.
That's his fifth. Well, it wasn't the way I thought they'd get the ball to Muhammad, but it worked out perfectly.
Bramlett's fifth. Yeah, that's his fifth, but they've already given the ball. This is interesting here. They've given the ball to the shooter. They didn't get Bramlett out of the game. He's going to have to come out now.
He's hiding. He was trying to hide, being rather coy about it. And now he gets a hug from Jason Terry.
Now,
Rick
wants another free throw.
I want that free throw back.
Yep. See, the referees had handed the ball to the shooter, Muhammad, which means then you can't get the substitute in. But Bramlett should have been taken out of the ball game before that had taken place.
Does Patino have a case?
No.
So Donnell Harris takes the spot of A.J. Bramlett. One more for Muhammad. He's 0 for 5 tonight from the line. They get 0 of 6. And a hack on Mercer. That's his fourth.
Well, you didn't want Mercer to commit the foul, but you don't mind Harris, who has banked one in tonight, who's a 58% free throw shooter, going to the line.
Now they call it on Mills. Let's scratch that. So Mercer with only 3-2 on Mills, and McGlure comes in for Muhammad. Muhammad hurt him tonight at the line, 0-6.
Well, you've got to get the ball down into him, though. Surprised that Rick is taking him out on this occasion. I thought maybe go that offensive-defensive shift and use McGlure on the defensive end. Expect Nazi to be back in here shortly.
Harris to give them the three-point edge. So both ends, the teams missed two free throws. 4 minutes to go in the overtime. 76-74, Arizona.
Terry chasing Mills every place he goes, knowing how he wants to get off the jumper.
Three, partially blocked. Mercer with Vivi trying to jar it loose, and Terry comes out with it.
Those incredibly quick hands by Terry tonight and Turner tonight and Vivi. Just amazing. No wonder he's the steal leader. Smart play to pull things out, settle down. And you know who's on the bench, Jim? Dickerson. Lute Olson sensing he just didn't have confidence in his offensive game. So his leading scorer is sitting.
Bibby.
No,
that was with three on the shot clock. Simon has to release it in time, and he got the rim.
No call.
Arizona retreat. That was a shot clock violation, and for a second I thought Arizona might come up with it. And then a foul, and then no whistle.
Well, you love to see intelligent plays. Simon pulls them time and time again. He knew exactly where that clock was.
Arizona calling for double dribble, but no whistle. Gadget on the drive. Harris inside for Arizona. And look at Terry. He dribbled it right around the Kentucky player. It goes in. Harris trailing. And McGlure got him.
Again, this incredible quickness by the big players from Arizona to get down on follow-ups. Everybody bending over, holding their pants right now. You know how exhausted they are. I said I thought Mercer was about 80%, about two-thirds of the way through the second half. He's a lot less than that now.
That was the fourth on McGlure. Harris back to the line. Now three straight misses in overtime. We have not had a field goal in the OT. Only the two free throws earlier.
Jim, important foul shot here. You get up three.
Two free throws by Davison. Muhammad back.
Dr. Muhammad returns to the collecting line for
the You remember Ron Mercer against Villanova that we had earlier this year? We were just explosive coming off of those screens. You can see now, as tired as he is, Simon able to stay with him. Here comes a screen.
Needing a three to tie. Obviously not having to take a three with 2:10 remaining. But not that urgent.
Yeah, plenty of time. But without Turner out there, they lose their key penetrator.
Epps had an open alley. Back of the rim blues, though.
And it's going to the other way.
It's going to be Terry. That's a foul on Mercer over the back of Terry, who has been all over it with loose balls and rebounds here in the overtime.
That's the fourth now on Mercer.
Terry is 70% free throw shooter.
Jason Terry.
Saw Terry on Turner tonight. Ted Turner Stadium. Kenny Lofton yesterday, the former Arizona player, hit the first home run ever out of Turner Stadium.
This kid originally committed to Washington orally and then signed with Arizona. For 3 years, he watched college basketball as close as he could get a ticket. He was a popcorn vendor at the University of Washington home games at Heck Edmondson Pavilion. All through his high school years,
those were clean.
Four, make it a five-point lead if he makes them both. 79-74. Inside 2 minutes. Kentucky has not scored in the overtime.
Part of that reason, again, is a lack of fresh legs.
Yes. Clutch again. Brings it to three.
Terry's really given a lift because now Simon and Bibby both can clear out. And Terry, with fresher legs, brings the ball up the court.
Minute 30 remaining.
Oh, again, Padgett gets caught. Terry should have kept the ball. Padgett got caught on a switch. Can happen again. If you're Arizona, just hold the ball right here and get in a 1-4 because you got Bibby against a man who can't guard him.
Huge possession if they can score here. Bibby. Harris. Foul.
Seems like Harris is living on the line, and you know, he said it. He looked at Simon, and Simon said something about the foul shots, and I could read his lips. He said, I got him.
Now he's laughing about it as Davison gave him a little tip. Give this kid all kinds of accolades, though, for his inside play with Bramlett having fouled out. Magic with four.
Now, is there blood again? Now we have Mills going out with blood on the knee. Rick Pitino saying, what else can happen to my team?
He's already had three stitches sewn into his chin.
Edwards, who unfortunately had an injury and missed the latter part of the season, so he hasn't been at full strength. We all know about Anderson not able to play at all, with the exception of shooting those two technicals. So Pitino has done wonders with this depleted club.
And Allen Edwards, as you say, less than 100% also. Two for Harris. Oh, yes.
Jim Lute Olson turned his back, walked down, drinking the water.
He's still not looking his way.
He doesn't want
to. He's not watching. He is not watching. Nor is Bobby. They turn around and gave it a little look out of the corner. But still, 1-2 gives him a 4-point lead. We approach the 1 minute mark.
Major possession here for Kentucky. They should be going for two, not worry about three.
This is the guy they want shooting. It's Padgett short. And Simon in the right spot again.
Simon wants to get fouled, Jim. He wants to get fouled.
And Mercer obliges and fouls out. Ron Mercer's career at Kentucky has come to a close.
Yes, Simon wanted to get fouled on that exchange. Instead of exploding out of there, there's Mercer going to go to the bench.
So they'll be shooting two free throws. This incredible tournament journey by Arizona. Already knocking out two number ones. Trying to knock out a third tonight. 41 seconds away from a national championship. They'll shoot free throws when we come back. After Arizona 80-76 in overtime. That was Kentucky's timeout, left with one full timeout. And Billy Mercer fouls out of the game with 13 points and 9 rebounds.
Another very smart play by Simon, Jim. He got the rebound. Instead of exploding out, he wanted to be fouled. I think he has such confidence in himself. And Mercer was trailing behind. Nothing he could do but reach on in there. So Kentucky really depleted now. Turner on the bench with fouls. Cricket on the bench with fouls. And now Ron Mercer on the bench with fouls. And Derek Anderson, who would have been an All-American this year, on the bench, not able to play because of injury.
Simon tonight with 26. He's made 10 of 13 free throws.
It was so interesting, Jim. Against North Carolina, with about 2 minutes to go, Simon ran by our broadcast position and said, we've got one more to go after this. That game was not yet over.
All 8 points in overtime for Arizona have come from the line. 6-point Arizona lead.
And that's why he wanted to be on the line.
Epps with a three.
Davison.
Davison had it stolen by Muhammad. Epps cut it in half. Bibby in the corner, who touched it last. Kentucky.
And Kentucky's got a foul now.
19 seconds remaining.
They have got to go through the fouling parade the rest of the way.
A steal by Muhammad. No, he had a foot on the line. Teddy Valentine was right there. Arizona ball.
Jimmy, down six. There's two possessions. You cannot afford to let Arizona take time off the clock with a dribble. Lute Olson going to take a timeout to get himself organized.
There it is. Timeout, Arizona. Only 14 seconds remaining in Indianapolis. Bobby Olson making her way to the court. Lute Olson's wife of 43 years and five kids. They've 11 grandchildren. Almost all their family resides in Tucson. Lute had two different opportunities to really get into the Kentucky mix, but he ended up staying because the family was all settled in Tucson. So anyone who's a grandparent can certainly understand how special that is. I never wanted to give it up.
Still just six, Jim. Two possessions with threes. You got to go for the steal and then foul. Got a foul.
Over to Simon, and Padgett commits it immediately.
But if you're Arizona, you've got to feel very comfortable with a guy by the name of Simon. We started the show saying Simon says, and he has said a lot. Look at that, Epps congratulating Simon, realizing that things are probably over here.
Padgett
he
is
fouled out. He fouled out.
That was his out of fouls also. 17 points, 14 of them coming in the second half. Steven Masiello has come in, a former Nick ball boy. They call him Rudy around here at Kentucky. He's come in now for the Wildcats of Rick Pitino. Two shots for Simon. When he's done at the line, he will have had as many attempts tonight as the Kentucky team, 17.
Jim, you're looking at the leading scorer in this year's NCAA tournament. 11 points, 20, 17, 30, 24, and then tonight the big night.
Will be no repeat. Bills with the three and a timeout, 6.4. 84-79, Arizona. 6.4 seconds remaining. Scott Padgett, one of four Kentucky players disqualified to fouls.
Jim, interesting time now for Arizona to go long, because Kentucky's not guarding the man taking the ball out of bounds, which means that if you break guys towards the basket, everybody's going to try to make the interception. Set a little screen and Simon or Bibby can go long.
Who else but Simon? They're not going to foul him. It's only right. The ball's in his hands. A milestone victory for Arizona.
Simon says championship. Thank you.
Olson for 13 years. Toiled as a high school coach in Minnesota. Orange County, California also was a U.S. history teacher at the same time. You just can't survive as a high school coach with five kids. He made a little history tonight, his team. The most amazing run this tournament has ever seen. In 11 days, they beat the three winningest programs in the history of college basketball, and all three were number one seeds.
To go before I sleep, Arizona will sleep all right, and they'll be dreaming about Miles Simon, who had 30 tonight. They're the national champions. Let's go back down to the celebration and our man Jim Nance. Jim?
All right, well, right here, Josh Pastner, one of the great supporters and members of this team. Miles Simon, what a game tonight. How did you guys pull off this upset?
I think we just wanted it more at the end. Coach, when we came to the overtime, you know, they had hit two big threes. Their legs were dragging. They were in foul trouble. We just wanted it more.
You know, you've been coming to Final Four since 1984, six times as a spectator. You've watched this scene from up in the stands. Did you ever imagine you'd be standing here tonight?
Nothing
like this?
Better than this. Nothing better. When I shoot my last free throws, I had chills run through my body. It's unbelievable. Unbelievable.
30 points tonight.
I heard you two talking about before. You still can't believe it. It's been a long wait, huh?
No, it's just, I mean, this won't sink in. It's like a dream. But the thing that I'm so pleased about is this is one tough group of cats. And they were not about, I mean, the whole thing we talked about in the locker room was the toughest team mentally and physically is going to win this basketball game. And it's interesting to see late, it wasn't us with our hands on our hips or our hands behind our head. The guys just did a great job of hanging in.
What is it like for all those years that he had to come home without the championship? How did you ever get him in this kind of framework to bring this team in here so positive?
I don't know. He's just so relaxed. It's wonderful. I think this team just relaxes him. The greatest win we've ever had.
Without question. Tremendous job.
This whole team's coming back. Some may go on to the NBA and say, show me the money. We say, show me the loot. Lute Olson, congratulations. Show us the trophy.
Hey, Pat.
Pat, back to you.
All right, Jim, stay out of that dancing situation. Tonight's Chevrolet players of the game, Miles Simon from Arizona, 30 points, tying a career high. And from Kentucky in a losing effort, and a great losing effort, Scott Pazzard had 17 points, 14 of them in the second half. Back upstairs here with Mike Krzyzewski and Clark Kellogg. And we were talking about, they're saying tough teams. Sometimes those tough teams kind of fizzle out at the end, but boy, these guys just gave the heat the whole game.
Oh, they really did. And you know, when this matchup was decided upon on Saturday, I said the team that played the hardest, the longest, and endured, I thought it was going to be purely a battle of wills, and it clearly was. Outstanding effort both ways. Arizona able to prevail the longest.
20 ties, 18 lead changes. Can't ask for a better game, Coach.
Lute Olson did a marvelous job, Pat. And the guard rebounding, Jason Terry, Donnell Harris, the kids off the bench gave valiant efforts. And really, when you take a look at the Kentucky Wildcats, what a courageous, valiant effort by those young men and their coaching staff.
Well, there they are, the national champions. And when you look back at this tournament, how many of you out there had them in your brackets? When we come back, the trophy presentation. And this is what it is about. Aerial shots provided by the Goodyear blimp. Coming up next on CBS, except on the West Coast, your late local news, followed by a late show with David Letterman and guest Brian Gumbel. Now let's send you courtside for the trophy presentation, and here's public address announcer Frank Fallon.
Your attention, please. To present the championship awards tonight, here's the chairman of the NCAA Division I Men's Basketball Committee, Mr. Terry Holland.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the NCAA and the Division I Men's Basketball Committee, I'd like to take this opportunity to congratulate two outstanding teams on their performance tonight and throughout the tournament. And now I hope you'll join me as I present the championship trophy to Coach Lute Olson and the Arizona Wildcats.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Terry. Thank you very much. What a great game. What a great effort from both teams. Neither team would yell, quit, right to the very end. And I think that's a credit to Coach Pitino and the outstanding team at Kentucky. But I'm very proud of the toughness of this group that no one thought should be here. No one thought could do it. Three number one seeds went down. This is one tough young group of cats. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the NCAA,
back upstairs, and Mike Krzyzewski, you've been there.
The greatest feeling in the world, and my first national championship was right on that floor, and I can understand how Lute Olson and those kids feel right now.
Clark, can we talk enough? Lute was saying this is one group of tough cats. Now, I could not believe these guys who kept coming back and coming back had the energy and the competitiveness and the skills and the guts to keep facing this tough Kentucky squad.
I think when you talk about this Arizona team, what characterizes them best is confidence, fearlessness, and resiliency. This team just continued to fight and fight, and they were able to outlast a very outstanding Kentucky club.
And one of the reasons they were able to, I think, is because Lute did such a great job resting his players down the stretch.
He did, and they really used a dribble. Dribble penetration equaled free throws and offensive rebound opportunities, and that's where the game was won.
You know what I liked about it, too, is that the fans here really embraced this game and loved it as it went into overtime. Andrea Joyce is downstairs with Rick Pitino.
All right, Pat, thank you. Coach, once again, as they have so many times this season, your kids came up with such a gutsy performance. How much was fatigue a factor late in the game and especially in overtime?
Oh, I'm sure it was, but they were fatigued also. I'm really proud of our book. I'm very happy for Lute Olson and the Arizona Wildcats. He's a coach that worked all his life for this moment. I wish we would have won, but I can't be any more proud of our basketball team. I was disappointed when we lost to Marquette in North Carolina, but I'm ecstatic at the effort that we got. Wish we could have won. But to the victor goes the spoils.
You have said all season long that this is a team that has played with more heart than any other team you've ever coached. How much more difficult does that make this for you tonight?
Oh, it's the most fun I've ever had as a coach, and I had a lot of fun tonight. I'm disappointed we didn't win it, but I walked off the court feeling so proud of them. Nobody likes to finish second. It's not what our country is built on. But I'm happy for Lute Olson, and I'm happy for our players, because this is what it's all about, that type of game. So I've got great pride.
They came so far and battled through adversity all season long. Anything you said to them tonight to kind of ease the pain of this?
All I told them, you're not champions with a second-place trophy, but you're champions inside. I said, you've got to give them credit, some of the players had big nights, but if you guys are disappointed right now, you don't understand the game of life. I said, because this is no upset in the Sweet 16 or even for that matter early in the tournament. I said, you were champions. You may not show it now, but it shows in life.
A courageous effort, a terrific season. Thanks so much for talking to
us. Thank you.
All right, back to you guys.
Nothing wrong with being number two at that age either. Now, somebody was thinking, guys, look at this. The Indianapolis Star, Arizona wins. Just landed here, 6 seconds left in the game, and the fans will go out tonight be able to pick that up from the Indianapolis Star. Join us for a racing doubleheader this weekend from the brand-new Texas Motor Speedway. NASCAR stars are in action beginning Saturday at 2 o'clock Eastern with the Coca-Cola 300 Grand National Race. Then on Sunday at 2 o'clock, it's the Interstate Batteries 500 featuring Winston Cup's top drivers. And don't forget, just under 2 weeks, we tee off our Masters coverage from Augusta National with late-night highlights on Thursday and Friday and third and final round coverage on Saturday and on Sunday. Well, Arizona, you've climbed up the beanstalk and knocked off the three biggest giants, college basketball's winningest programs, Kentucky, North Carolina, and Kansas. And as we say goodbye, we'd like to thank all the players, coaches, and schools, as well as the people behind the scenes who brought all the exciting sights and sounds of the games into your homes. As for the players who make this thing sing, well, some go home winners, And some go home with memories. And they all go home with the opportunity to someday tell their kids that their daddy played in the 1997 NCAA tournament. And some, they'll get to say, your daddy had a shiny moment. Good night, everybody.
Is tipped. There you are. You're running for your life. You're a shooting star. All those years, no one knows just how hard you worked. But now it shows that one shining moment you reached deep inside. In one shining moment. Feel the beat of your heart, feel the wind in your face. It's more than a contest, it's more than a race. Your best, cause inside you knew that one shining moment you reached for the sky. One shining moment you knew. One shining moment you willing to try. One shining moment you
But going the other way, Mike Bibby to A.J. Bramlett. And Bramlett goes up and banks it in. Then Michael Dickerson outside, swish, and he trips over Rick Pitino. Arizona by one at the half. Now 19 seconds left, regulation. Bibby to Bennett Davison, and it's Arizona by three. But with 13 seconds left in regulation, Anthony Epps' three-pointer in the game goes into overtime. And the overtime, Arizona did not make a basket, but made 10 foul shots, including Miles Simon High.